Hi, I'm Miwa Matreyek, and I'm an animator, designer, and performer based in Los Angeles. I make multimedia shows that combine animation and theater. I project the animations that I make onto a screen from two projectors, from the front and from the back, and I create a shadow with my body to tell dreamlike stories about the world. With the two layers of projection, I can create complex illusions of an immersive world that my body is a part of. My newest piece is called Infinitely Yours. This piece is about climate change, the human impact on the Earth, and my own climate grief that I was processing. I chose the title Infinitely Yours while thinking about how long plastic takes to break down. I was also thinking about how all the life here on Earth is made out of recycled materials. The stuff that make up our bodies used to be part of the food that we eat, whether it be animal or plant, which in turn was part of animal, plant, or earth. When we contaminate the planet, we contaminate ourselves. When we destroy nature, we destroy ourselves. The inspiration for creating this piece came from news items that I was reading, listening to, and watching over the last 4 to 5 years that were growing more and more alarming about unprecedented wildfires, floods, destructive storms, sea level rise, droughts, famines, pollution, and contamination. As well as the cycles of overextraction from land clearing for farming, fish population collapse from overfishing, and destructive extractions of fossil fuels and natural gases. I was bookmarking these news items in an app called Evernote. It was a way to catalog the information and to start imagining how I might turn these news information into visual images and moments of performance. Because my work integrates my animation as well as my own body and shadow, I wanted the moments and experiences of climate change to look like they directly affect my body. I was interested in sudden flips in who the shadow figure might represent. Some of the moments, I'm an individual person experiencing the world. But sometimes my shadow represents all of humanity, and yet again, sometimes the Earth itself. My shadow flips between being the destroyer and the destroyed. The shadow drowns in the ocean full of plastic, screams in traffic, and guzzles oil. In a lot of the moments in this piece, I am integrating videos and photos from my daily life. The garbage floating just under the waves were all videos I shot of plastic trash I pulled out of the blue bin of my building, with a good portion of it being my own. The process of making this work actually made me reassess my own plastic consumption, leading me to do monthly audits where I held onto the trash headed for the recycling bin for a whole month so I could take a look at all I've amassed in the month. This helped me assess where I can make different shopping choices, what I can reuse, and research further into what I can actually recycle in my area. I wanted this piece through live performance to give a nightmarish, visceral way to communicate ideas to the audience. For example, there is the statistic that the average American creates 4.4 pounds of trash a day. What does it mean when you multiply that by a week, a month, a year, or a lifetime, or a whole household? What would it feel like for all that trash to come pouring out of your body? It has been interesting that as I show this work, there are scenes that continue to feel relevant with unfolding world events. The opening scene with the forest fire, I first imagined with the fires in California, but then felt relevant again and again with the Amazon rainforest fires and then the fires in Australia.